Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, if you've got a bad habit of constantly looking at, yes, this right here, your smartphone, you are not alone. Thank you. But if you're a parent, you're getting a bad rap. That's right. New study reveals that smartphones may not be such a smart choice when it comes to parenting. This study observed several parents in several different fast food restaurants, and the people who were engrossed in their smartphones responded less. What? Huh? And more harshly than those who use their phones only to make phone calls.
So this is so true.
You
know, it's hard because obviously everyone has a smartphone
yes,
at this day and age.
They do.
And there are barely any parents out there who really don't work. I mean, times have changed.
Yeah, you
and
have
now
to.
Both parents work, so a lot is happening on their phone. They need
right,
to be in constant contact.
Mm-hmm.
We just had Sierra on. She said a lot of people own their own business.
Sure.
So maybe that's how it's done, spending time with your kids and kind of handling your
right,
business on your own smartphone. But I feel like if once you are with your kids and they are there, that is such a crucial time for them, especially when they're young and they're growing up.
Yeah.
And if they're saying, Mom, Mom, Dad, look at me.
Right.
They want that. They want that interaction. They don't want to feel
they're competing against the iPhone or
exactly,
something else.
Exactly. Or they're being reprimanded for just wanting attention
right,
from their parent.
I find myself, like, at dinner time, I won't use the smartphone.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put it down if it's aside of me, but I'm not someone who's constantly picking it up and looking at it. Other times, if I'm sitting down watching TV, there, I'll mm-hmm, have an iPad or something like that, and I do. You get to that point where you're so engrossed in whatever it is that
mm-hmm,
you're reading, whether it's a newspaper online or whether it's, you know, some website you're on. You get so focused in on that, you almost block out everything
yes,
else that's around you, and you don't hear the other person,
mm-hmm,
the other, you know, person talking to you. And last night in my house, one of my daughters, you know, the kids are more obsessed than I am. One of my daughters last night had drained the battery because she had the thing on, so two iPads she had gone through and was searching for mine last night, looking to charge it. I said, we're going to have to hook up a generator to charge all the things up. It's like, give it a break.
It is, and it's hard because we live in a society where we are so connected,
yeah,
and we need to stay connected
yes,
at every moment of every day. And heck, I've even been mid-text, and if I'm trying to have a conversation, I'll text the word that I just said to you,
yeah,
and it makes no sense
right,
in my text.
Yeah.
Or I'll stop mid-sentence and say, what were we talking about?
Right.
Because it's hard to carry on both things at once.
Yeah, and at one point, even yesterday, I was getting texts from somebody and then someone else was texting. I ended up sending the wrong text to the other person. I'm like, nope, sorry, not you,
yep,
wrong person. You
exactly,
know, but it happens. You get so engrossed in it.
But I'd rather have the distractions happen when you sit at the table
yes,
than, God forbid, driving in a car.
Right. Yeah, don't
and
do that.
Now here's your technology.
Not good.
And things get very dangerous. All right, Brennan. Distracted much?
Huh? I'm sorry. Oh, the show's on. I had no idea. Well, our Facebook friends have many comments about this topic today. Mike Colalella gets things started saying, I see it all the time when I take my daughter to the playground.
Mm-hmm.
These parents just let their kid run around like banshees, causing trouble. Then they get angry because they have to pause their Candy Crush to discipline their kids. Technology ruined everything.
They could get hurt, though,
they
too.
Could.
Absolutely.
They're not paying attention.
Carol Sandre Saro, one of my favorite names, she adds, just yesterday, I saw parents at the playground glued to their phones while their kids were trying to get their attention.
Mm-hmm.
Sad that they're missing such special moments.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And finally, Joe, and finally,
and
Sloppy
finally,
Joe, there we go, leaves us with a thought-provoking comment. She says, I am not surprised by this finding. I am imagining a quiet evening at home with the parents sitting on the couch, looking at their phones while the kids, unfortunately very young ones too, watching TV. Such wonderful quality family time. Thank you, technology. What will the future bring? Well, there you go. Great comments from our Facebook friends, as always, and trending today from the New England Tech Center, of course. Well, we all know that President Obama has a great sense of humor. This is true. From appearing on late night talk shows to never being afraid of making fun of himself, the commander-in-chief knows what's funny. Well, never has that been more apparent than in the latest episode of Zach Galifianakis's public access talk show spoof, Between Two Ferns, in which Obama appeared as a guest. Take a look at a few quick clips.